Hey there, my name is Joe Acaba, and I'm living and working on the International Space Station as part of Expedition 53. One of the best parts about living on the space station is being able to float. Just like you walk from place to place throughout your day, we float from place to place throughout our day. However, we have learned that the same thing that allows us to float, microgravity, is hard on our bodies over time. Our muscles and bones are made of millions of tiny units called cells, and these cells can have problems in microgravity. Up here on the station, bones and muscles no longer have to support the weight of our bodies, so they get weaker. Astronauts could develop something called muscle atrophy, where our muscles become weak from lack of use. Each bone in your body is made of cells too. A healthy bone has more density than an unhealthy bone. Weakened bones can lead to a disease called osteoporosis. Fortunately, our scientists at NASA have figured out one way to keep astronauts healthy and strong. It's called exercise. Let's take a look at how astronauts exercise in space. This machine here is the Advanced Resistive Exercise Device, or we call it AREG. It simulates free weight exercises in normal gravity to work all the major muscle groups. AREG's primary goal is to maintain our muscle strength and mass so that we have less of a recovery period when we land back on Earth. All right, so there's looking at lifting. But what about a little cardio? We have a treadmill for that. Let's check it out. Staying physically active helps both astronauts in space and humans on the ground to stay healthy. And it prevents muscle atrophy and osteoporosis. Now you can try the activity connected to this video to learn more about muscle and bone cells. I'm Joe Acaba, and I hope you enjoyed learning about exercise on the International Space Station. We'll see you next time.
Subscribe for more space.